Mary, who deserved Christ to live in her womb. تخيلوا بقى. يبقى أنا لازم إن أنا أعيش حياة توبة وحياة جديدة في المسيح اللي هي تخلي تؤهلني إن أنا أتناول. By fasting, number three, we spoke about that. Reconciliation with others. We spoke about that in details. لما برضو when we studied the Didache, we will stress this point. It's very important. And last point is there is physical and mental preparation. يعني we have to be clean even physically, representing the inner cleanliness, etc. When we come early to church, we participate in the prayer that's being performed in the church to prepare us also for the service. يعني في تخيلوا في عدد كبير من الابسوليوشنز من كم حل ناخده في الكنيسة قبل ما بنتناول كتير. اللي بيجي في الآخر ويتناول ده بيخسر كتير. إنه ما في ساعات صدقوني في ناس تصدقوا خش من الباب خش على الطابور التناول. ايه ده؟ مش فاهم انا. تعرفين زمان؟ مفروض نرجع نطبق الحاجات دي. زمان the way it was when there was no liturgy without the bishop. Because in the understanding of the church the bishop should be the icon of Christ and so anyway he's the high priest as Christ is the high priest. There was only one bishop and one church in a city. And everyone gathers before the bishop comes. They gather before the bishop comes. No one enters the church. And then once the bishop enters, and everyone, that's why that was the big atrium outside of the church. هي عارفين المدخل بتاع الكنيسة ده كان يبقى واسع قوي. زي الحوش دلوقتي كده كانوا يتجمعوا فيه. And then the bishop enters the church. And the people enter, then the service starts and the doors are locked. That's it. No one can enter the church after that. دلوقتي بنخش نلاقي الكنيسة فاضية. مش حد. ناس فقدت المعاني الروحية اللي ورا الحاجات دي. عشان نرجع طبعا المفاهيم دي. دلوقتي يقول لك ايه؟ هو الإنجيل امتى؟ اتضايق قوي انا بقى. اللي يسأل السؤال ده انت مالك الانجيل امتى يعني انت عايز تظبط نفسك على الانجيل مين قال some people have the idea if I don't attend the gospel reading I cannot take communion who said you should come from the beginning not from the gospel reading what about the readings before that what about the agbaya what about the prayers what about the salawat what about baker كل ده مش مهم ده مش يعني ايه المفهوم الغريب ده حاجات عايزة تتصلح كتير عند الناس. And that's why there are prayers and rituals. That's why it's important to attend the service from the beginning. The catechumens used to attend the liturgy from the beginning and they leave after the ceremony. After they attend the ceremony, they have to leave because they are not yet baptized. And then the faithful remain in the church to the end to receive communion. Everyone receives communion at that time. Saint Athanasius has a very nice saying that I'm going to read to you again. He says, "You shall see the Levites bringing loaves and a cup of wine." Who are the Levites? Lewiyin. مين هم؟ دولت في العهد القديم أولا يعني دولت الخدام الهيكل. طب why is he saying you shall see the Levites؟ احنا سبناهم دولت في العهد القديم. Do you know why? So this is the icon of the church, the bishop, the priests around the bishop. And that's why the throne of the bishop was in the sanctuary in الشرقية. How do you mean? The priests and then the deacons. The servants and the people. This is the icon of heaven. Why? Because Christ is in the center with the apostles. يقول تجلسون على إثنى عشر كرسيا, right? وتدينون صبات إسرائيل إثنى عشر. So the priests here in this image represent the apostles, and then the deacons, who are the servants, represent the angels, and we have the people. That's why we say that the church is the icon of heaven. كما في السماء كذلك على الأرض. يبقى لما يقول هنا بقى بيستعير التشبيه, بيقول لك هتلاقي الشمامسة بقى. فلما يقول الشمامسة بيقول الايه, الليفايتس اللي هم في العهد القديم كانوا خدام الهيكل. You shall see the Levites bringing loaves and a cup of wine. كان ليها procession على فكرة, يعني التقديمات دي كان ليها procession معين. فمين اللي بيشيلهم؟ الشماس. And placing them on the table. The altar is called here the table. So long as, بصوا الحتة دي مهمة جدا 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 عشان to understand our, what's our understanding of the Eucharist. إيه الخبز والخمر؟ Listen. So long as the prayers of supplication and entreaties have not been made, there is only bread and wine. Guys, they bring in bread and wine. But after the great and wonderful prayer have been completed, then the bread has become the body and the wine the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. كلام في منتهى القوة. And again, let us approach the celebration of the mysteries. This bread and this wine, so long as the prayers and supplications have not taken place, remain simply what they are. ببساطة, what they are. But after the great prayers and holy supplications have been sent forth, the word comes down into the bread and wine, and thus his body is confected. Saint Athanasius the Apostolic. Saint Cyril of Jerusalem approached the minister of baptism, but not approaching, think not of the face of him you see, but remember the Holy Spirit of whom we are now speaking. He wants to say it doesn't matter who the one performing the sacrament or the mystery, but remember that it is the Holy Spirit who's actually working. As in the mother's womb lies the power to give the physical life, likewise the power, the water of baptism has received power to give spiritual life. In the mother's womb, this is a mystery. زي الجنين بيتكون في البطن ويطلع من البطن حياة جديدة. حاجة عجيب. So he's saying here, as in the mother's womb lies the power of to give life, so in the baptism. After the invocation prayer, the matter is no longer simply what it is, but it receives from the Holy Spirit the power to give a specific grace to the believer. And then we give the example of the magnet. Magnet عبارة عن إنه إيه؟ Piece of iron, right? But then it becomes a magnet. If you pass electricity through it, or you strike it in a certain manner, then it becomes a magnet. It has the power to attract pieces of iron. How? It received something that made it has something new to its nature. كده يعني حتة الحديدة ايه المغناطيس عبارة انه حتة حديدة يمشوا عليه ماجنت برضو تاني او سترايكت بطريقة معينة تلقوها بقت ماجنت تلقط حاجات. طب ايه اللي حصل؟ ما هي ماجنت برضو، هل غيرت طبيعتها ولا هي لسه ماجنتيك او لا هي لسه ايرن؟ يعني طبيعتها لسه ايرن، ما غيرتش طبيعتها. عشان كده لما تبص على الخبز انت بتشوف ايه؟ تشوف خبز؟ تشوف حاجه غير خبز؟ تشوف طعم غير الخبز؟ هو زي ما دخل، زي ما بنت، بس في بالايمان بنقول the Holy Spirit has descended upon the material and they are no longer what they merely are. They have received certain gift from the Holy Spirit that makes, that gives them this new power. Okay. ظن ده مثل مفهوم كويس يعني. The handkerchiefs and the aprons of St. Paul. بعد حاجة biblical. The handkerchief is the same material, just a normal handkerchief, and maybe they made many handkerchiefs from the same piece of cloth. مش كده؟ نفس الماتيريال قطعوها عملوا منها مثلا 50 منديل. لكن المنديل بتاع سانت بول بالذات is the one that has this power. Why? Because it is the handkerchief of Saint Paul. Then it has a certain blessing from him. It became a blessing. وهكذا يعني. This is the idea that we as Orthodox have, that we use material a lot and touching, and we use the senses, right? We use touching, we take a blessing through touching, we take a blessing through smell, like the incense. That's why we use a lot of incense. We sing so that to sanctify our ears. We taste, ناكل زي ما في التناول, to sanctify our sense of taste. So we use our whole being in worship. نستخدم كل كياننا في العبادة. But we don't say, oh, let's spiritualize everything. No, doesn't work this way because we are human. We are part body and part spirit. So the matter receives an energia from the Holy Spirit so that it is no longer simply what it, or merely what it is, but it's an invisible power that the material conveys, etc. Let's move to the following lecture. Then we started to speak about priesthood in the New Testament. In order to understand the Eucharist, remember what we said? We need, who is the servant of the Eucharist? خادم السر. We said it is the priest. But then we are faced with a problem. In the Protestant churches, they refuse the idea of priesthood. They say one of two things. There's only one priest or high priest, who is Jesus, or there is general priesthood. Everyone is a priest. If you have a problem now, كلنا كهنة أو ما فيش غير كهن واحد اللي هو مسيح رئيس كهن. طبعا وفي آيات. We're not going to go through everything because this is supposed to be a revision, right? Remember? So we proved that there is one high priest, who is Jesus Christ, and there is the general priesthood of all believers, and we understood this in the light of the spiritual sacrifices that any believer can offer. And these are the spiritual gifts that we can offer, 10 of them: the sacrifice of worship, sacrifice of praise, ذبيحة التسبيح, the sacrifice of thanksgiving, 10 of them. Here they are. And then we divided them into three kinds of spiritual sacrifices: worship and praise, or of charitable deeds, or virtuous life. For obedience, مثلا, we sacrifice our will. يعني when you sacrifice your will, then this is obedience. مش كده؟ Obedience is supposed to be a spiritual father, to a spiritual father who will guide you. So you sacrifice your own will to do the will of your spiritual father. بتقدم ذبيحة اسمها ذبيحة الطاعة. Okay. هكذا. There are spiritual sacrifices which all believers can offer, which makes each person a spiritual priest. Even females, not only males. This is for all the general faithful. We have verses for everything. And we have Christ as the official and the head of priesthood, the high priest. But then, are there ordained ministers? This is the point. Ordained ministers. Ordained priests. أمال إحنا هنبقى إيه بقى؟ لو ما فيش. And so we had to speak about the idea of priesthood without the priestly function that we are used to, like offering bloodly sacrifices. So I read in His Holiness's book, His Holiness Pope Shenouda, about John the Baptist, for example. Did you ever hear about John the Baptist offering any sacrifices? But he is a priest because he is the son of a priest. But his priesthood was a mission that was given to him. So this is a new kind of priesthood. Not necessarily a priest who stays in the altar and offers sacrifices. In order to prove that there is priesthood in the New Testament, we had to prove that there is an altar, في مزبح. Because if there is an altar, then there has to be a priest in the New Testament. And we proved that. These are the verses. The altar of the New Testament, these are the verses. Isaiah, Hebrews, Isaiah 19, you know, the my prophecy about Egypt, the altar in Egypt. And in Hebrews and in Matthew, Malachi and others. So there is an altar in the New Testament. And then we prove that there is a sacrifice in the New Testament, فيزبيح. المسيح بيقول ايه؟ Do this in remembrance of me. We have so many verses here which we're not going to read now. But let me ask a question to you again. We say that all the sacrifices of the Old Testament were symbols of the sacrifice of the cross. They were the shadows of the things to come. ظلال الأمور العتيدة. This is what they were in the Old Testament, right? Therefore, why don't we apply this on the priesthood itself? So, the priesthood of the Old Testament were the shadows of the priesthood of the New Testament. So we are the real priests because we are offering the real sacrifice. They were the symbolic priesthood because they offer the symbol. إيه رأيكم في المفهوم ده؟ يعني هو كاهن حقيقي طب ده بيقدم ذبيحة رمزية لأنها بترمز لذبيحة المسيح. طب أمال مين اللي بيقدم الذبيحة الحقيقية؟ هو كاهن العهد الجديد وبياخد كهنوته من كهنوت المسيح اللي هو قدم نفسه ذبيحة. يبقى الكهنوت الحقيقي هو كهنوت العهد الجديد مش كهنوت العهد القديم. Since there is an altar and sacrifice in the New Testament, therefore it requires the priest. And the priest offers the sacrifice of the New Testament, which is the sacrifice of Christ. وبعدين بقى, we actually proved that there is the word priests in the New Testament in various locations. We'll take one more lecture today. We started to speak about the priest of the New Testament, that he has a special calling and ordination, يعني له دعوة خاصة, وعنده various ranks. It's not just all of them are the same. And then they have distinctive titles. They have distinctive titles that distinguishes them from the other faithful. If everybody was the same priest, then why do we give certain titles to the priests? لو الكتاب المقدس اتكلم على specific titles وفي specific calling وبعدين درجات كهنوتية زي ما اتعلم, وكل ده في الاخر هنقول مفيش priesthood, امال ده كله ايه يعني؟ كل ده من الكتاب المقدس. طيب, so that in terms of the special calling, we have the 12 and have the 72. We'll give so many examples. And the appointment of the priests. We can go through a lot of details, but as I said, I'm trying to give an overview of what we have already discussed in detail. So this is all about the appointment of the priests. They have their appointment and they have special ordination, like the laying of the hands. مش كده؟ في حاجة اسمها وضع اليد. وضع اليد له في وضع اليد للبركة ووضع اليد للشفاء وفي وضع اليد للكهنوت. For healing, for blessing, for prayer, and for ordination. These are the four types الموجودين عندنا هنا. دي اللي قلتها لكم من شوية. His Holiness Pope Shenouda, he said, and we notice too that the purpose of John's priesthood was to bear witness to the light and not to concentrate on offering sacrifices. God sent him forth and defined a specific mission which he was to undertake as a priest, which was not to offer sacrifices but to preach the baptism of repentance and prepare people's heart and minds to receive the Lord. يبقى هنا نوع كهنوت مش ان هو يقدم ذبائح دموية او حيوانية, لكن ان هو مش معينة يعمل ايه, يعد الشعب ازاي بالمعمودية, ادي الكهنوت بتاعه. بعدين عملنا comparison يعني the essence or the outcome of that comparison, I remember that the priest of the Old Testament, what he did was to offer the animal. But the priest of the New Testament, through his preaching, does what? As it says here, the people, when they heard St. Peter, they were cut to the heart. نُخُسِفُ كُلُبْهُمْ by the word of God, which is sharper than any two-edged sword. يعني أمضى من أي سيف ذي حدين. كأن كلمة ربنا اللي بيمسكها الكاهن أو اللي بيعلم بيها الكاهن بقت هي سكينة الإيه؟ الكاهن في العهد القديم. يبقى هو الكاهن عمله ماسك السكينة والسيف، بس سيف الروح هو كلمة ربنا اللي بيها بينخس قلوب الناس يقودهم إلى حياة التوبة. فإلا أحسن أن أنا أخلي من خلال الكلمة أخلي الناس يقدموا حياتهم لربنا سكريفايس، ولا أن أنا مجرد بقدم ذبيحة حيوانية؟ بلا شك كهنوت العهد الجديد اللي هو بيقدم قلوب الناس بالحب على المذبح الإلهي أعظم بما لا يقاس من كهنوت العهد القديم، مش كده؟ طبعا. فبس ده كان محاضرة على بعضيها يعني، بس ده the gist of the whole thing. So then therefore the priesthood of the New Testament is much greater, since they through their ministry they offer not but bloodly sacrifices but the whole person as a living sacrifice. هي دي بقى النقطة. افتكر this is a good spot to stop. يبقى عملنا النهاردة ايه؟ 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 5 lectures. I have a questions, one question from last week that I wish to answer. Question, I'll read it in Arabic. كيف أحب الله ليس حب الاحتياج وليس حب الخوف ولكن حب العبادة. And I'm glad, let me just translate. How can I love God? Not the kind of love that requests because of the need, or that is a fearful love, but to love Him and to worship Him because of who He is. Because really, these are the three levels by which we may understand our relationship with God. Some of us may love God simply because we are afraid of Him. Some of us may love God because we want something from Him. And some of us love God because we love Him for who He is. So let's understand each one. The first kind, we call it the love of the slave. It depends on fear. العبد هو يخاف من الماستر. The second kind, which is the love that depends on the need. Is the love of the hireling. Hireling اللي هو الأجير. The third kind of love is the love of the children. يبقى حب الايه؟ حب العبد بيعتمد على الخوف، بيخاف من السيد. حب الأجير يعتمد على الايه؟ انا في النهايه عايز الاجر، اشتغلت لك جيت لك يا رب وصليت لك اهو اديني بقى ايه عايز شغلانه عايز زوج عايز زوجه عايز امتحان عايز شفاء عايز اي حاجه من الحاجات اللي بنقعد نطلبها ودي اللي صدقوني اغلبنا بنطلبها هو عبادتنا فعلا عباده اجراء اجراء كلنا بلا استثناء تقريبا مين فينا ما بيقفش قدام ربنا ويطلب منه حاجه كلنا كل واحد نفسه في حاجه هيقف قدام ربنا ويصلي له عشان محتاج الحاجه دي حب العبد هو الخوف لا 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 ربنا ده يقولك لاني سمعت عنك انك رجل قاسي فخفت سمع عن ربنا someone may hear about God and may fear him not the fear that leads to love but to be scared of what he may do to me he will punish me here on earth and in the everlasting life that's why some people may say why am I suffering is God punishing me for my sins this is sometimes we feel this way right حالا بنشعر بكده هو ربنا بيعاقبني عشان انا خط ما كلنا خطاه لو كلنا ربنا يعني بنقول ان كنت للاثام راصدا يا رب يا رب من يثبت لانه من عندك المغفره كانش فينا حد يبقى ماشي على رجليه لو ربنا كل حاجه طخ 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 ربنا مش كده الله محبه therefore if we feel that God is punishing us because of our sins we are never going to love him It's a wrong understanding of our relationship with God. واحد يقول ايه؟ واحد يقول انا ادفع العشور لاحسن ربنا ياخد كله. او ادفع العشور عشان ربنا يبارك اكتر فيبعت لي اكتر. فشوفي دي حب الايه؟ الاولانية الخوف عشان ربنا ياخد الباقي. والتانية ايه؟ عشان ربنا يبارك ان انا محتاج هيبارك لي فهيزود هيزود يبقى ده الاحتياج كان واحد يقول انا بحب ادي لربنا عشان ربنا من يدك اعطيناك تديتني كتير يا رب وديتني بزياده فانا عايز ادي لاخواتي ادي للمحتاج الاخر شوفوا الفرق بين الثلاثه عشان كده مثلا بنقول الفرض فروض يعني ايه الفرض هل أنا بصلي عشان أنا مفروض أصلي فرض عليا ولا بصلي عشان بحبك ببقى فرحان وأنا بصلي اللي عايز يصلي عشان هو فرض تلاقيه عايز يصلي ويخلص لأنه مش فرحان هو بيصلي بيعملها كفرض حركات نازل طالع rituals we do things out of rituals not out of love or out of fear because if I don't do it some problems will befall me or befall me so I better do it just to avoid any يعني anger from God these are the three types but I haven't spoken how to love God this is not the answer yet I'm just saying defining the three kinds But how to love God is to practice. To be honest with myself, why do I love Him? Is it out of fear, out of need, or because I love Him without any need? سيدنا البابا عشان شاعر كان يقول إيه؟ هل أحب الله لذاته أم لأجل لذاته؟ لذاته هو يعني ولا من أجل لذاته الحاجات اللي بيديها لنا لكم ترنيمة نختم بها مفادها الكلام اللي بنقوله ده موجودة صفحة 291 تقول إيه إني أحب الرب لا لأربح النعيم ولا لكي أنجو من العذاب في الجحيم. انت مش عارفينها؟ طب ما تقول. انا بقول عشان تقولوا معايا مش عشان تسمعوني. إني أحب الرب لا لأربح النعيم ولا لكي أنجو من العذاب في الجحيم لكن أحبه لأن لي حبه يحلو وهو الذي من فضله أحبني قبله لكن أحبه لأن لي حبه يحلو وهو الذي من فضله أحبني قبل. يعني هي ترنيمة كويسة. إني أحب الرب لا لأربح النعيم. لا لأربح النعيم دي اللي هي الاحتياج. ده مستوى الايه؟ مستوى مين ده؟ مستوى الاجير. بعمل حاجه عشان هاخد حاجه في النهايه. ثانيه ولا لكي انجو من العذاب في الجحيم. دي مستوى الايه؟ الخوف. مستوى العبد. لكن احبه لان لي حبه يحلو. فرحان في عشرتي معه. وهو الذي من فضله احبني قبله. نحن نحبه لانه حبنا أولا. تفضلوا نصلي. Finally, O Lord, make us all worthy to pray thankfully and say, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come on earth as it is in heaven, and give us this day, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. In Christ Jesus our Lord, for thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory. May the love of God the Father and the grace of his only begotten Son, our Lord, God and Savior, Jesus Christ, the gift and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you. Go in peace. And may the peace of God be with you. Tomorrow, next week, we will continue our revision until we finish in a couple of weeks, hopefully, and then we begin new topics on the Eucharist, inshallah.